Hey everyone, Nick here again, and today I want to talk to you about how to analyze your zip codes. If you work for a visitor serving organization like a museum, zoo, aquarium, you are probably so familiar with tracking your attendance. You get your quarterly or your annual attendance reports. And one thing that we always usually ask our visitors is, what was your zip code? And so by the end of the year, we have thousands, tens of thousands, maybe even millions of zip codes that you have to analyze. It can be a little bit daunting, especially if you don't know where to go. And I think a lot of people think you need a fancy subscription to some zip code aggregator site, or maybe even a fancy software like Tableau or even Power BI. You don't need those softwares to analyze your zip codes and get some really useful information from them. And you can do it for free using the software that you already have access to. And by that, of course, I mean good old Microsoft Excel. So in this video series, I'm going to create a playlist about how to analyze your zip codes. I'm not sure how many videos is going to be included in that playlist yet, but start from this one. This is your introduction, and what we're going to do is create this playlist, create this video series, so that it's a step-by-step instructional tutorial, the click-by-click how-to of how I analyze my zip codes from start to finish inside Microsoft Excel. If you don't have that much experience with Excel, don't worry. You're going to be able to follow these videos, start and stop and rewatch them as many times as you want to. The first thing that we need to do is download a current US zip code database. And I'm going to show you the website that I like to do that from for free. You probably have your own sources, and I would love to hear them. So please put them put those in the comments so that we can all learn together. Later on down the line, I'm going to create some videos on how we can use XLOOKUP or VLOOKUP formulas inside of Excel so that we can get information from our big US zip code database, compare and pulling those into our own zip code databases. We'll be able to get our city, county, and state information right from our zip code list right inside of Excel. We're also going to work with that US zip code database to transform some of that data into custom variables that we have of interest. So what I mean by that is, maybe we have a question like, how many of our visitors are from out of state versus in state? We're going to be able to create dummy variables or custom variables inside our US zip code database, and we're going to be able to use that to pull some of that data from based on the zip code list that we have. So I'm going to show you how to do that in a video in this series as well. And then finally, we are going to use pivot tables to summarize our data. It's so easy to do. I know that pivot tables sound really complicated and intimidating, and they definitely sounded intimidating to me when I first started out. But as soon as I learned how to do it, it was surprising to me how simple they are and how easy they are to work with. So once you do one pivot table, you're never going to want to go back. You're going to want to put pivot tables into all of your spreadsheets from here on out. Okay, so we're going to go to step number one. That's download the U.S. Postal Service zip code database now. So go to www.unitedstateszipcodes.org. I'm going to click that link right here, and you'll see it'll pop up this website on the home page. There's a lot of cool features that you can sort of poke around here, scroll around, but what I want you to do now is go up to this right hand tab that says zip code database. Click on that, and then here is where you can download this for free. Now, it's not exactly free because you do have to give an email address. So if that's an issue for you, keep on searching. There might be other resources out there where you can find one of these. There's also paid or commercial options of this database that you can download. Some of them come with some really fancy lookup bells and whistles. They come with additional census-based information like age, gender, race, things like that from those zip codes. But today we're actually just going to download the free version. That's all I really want. When you click that, it's going to ask you what format you want to download it. I like to download it in CSV format. It still opens in my Excel database, but I find it's easier to work with. You could also download it just in Excel, just the data only. That would be perfect. And then there's another option that they have for you to download the Excel format with quick lookup. That just has a few more tabs on it with some lookup features that are kind of interesting. But today we really just need it in the data only. So you can go ahead and download Excel format or CSV format. When you click that, I'll go ahead and click it so you can see what happens. It just gave me the database now, but if this is your, I think it's because I did it once before, but if this is your first time on that website, it's going to ask you what this is for. Go ahead and click nonprofit project or other, and then put in your email address, and then they will allow you to download this database right here. This database will pop up right here, and you can see we have a header column, a header row right here. I'm just gonna go ahead and make these bold right now. And then what I'm gonna go do is go up to the View tab on the ribbon, and I'm gonna go ahead and go to the Freeze Panes drop-down menu and just select Freeze Top Row. When we freeze the top row, now when I scroll through this database, that top row will stay there, it'll stay consistent so I can see all of the zip codes there. But you can see it's gonna be sorted from lowest number all the way up to highest number. Another trick when you have so many columns or so many rows of data, you could go over here to the scroll bar and just go all the way down. You can see we have, let's see, we have 42,725 rows of data here. Let's go back up to the top. I'll show you another little Excel keyboard shortcut trick that I love. If you're in here in A2, in this first cell right here, and you go ahead and push the Shift key and the down arrow key, that's gonna take you to the very last piece of data in that column, or it's gonna take you to the last piece of data before there's a space. So go ahead and push Shift and down arrow. Ooh, that actually just highlights everything. Sorry, I actually meant control and down arrow. So we're just gonna go ahead and click control and then down arrow, and that takes you immediately to that final step. You can click the control and up arrow, and that'll take you to the top row too. So that's just a little way that you can navigate through this website. But this is all you need for this video. Stay tuned for the next video, and we'll start sort of working with our, we'll start setting up our zip code lookup database, and then we'll import our list of zip codes and really get everything set up so that we can start analyzing them perfectly. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to get notified each time I post a new video on DataViz, presentation design, report design using Excel and PowerPoint. Everyone can be a professional designer. You don't need fancy software to do it. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.